Hello everyone and welcome back to more SnowRunner hard mode. We're still working on our out with the old contract. We have one more thing left to do, and that's get that oil rig drill over here. So it's been a while since we used it, but we're gonna hook up this GMC. It's not stuck. I don't even know what I'm connected to. Oh, that over there. Is there something anywhere else? Alright, what if I do this manually? Yeah, so we're gonna use this. Can I? Try to get unstuck from here. Come on. Come on. This truck has been nothing but a disappointment the entire time I've used it for anything. What are you? Can you grab onto that thing right in front of you? No, I'm just gonna grab on to everything else. Please let me use this. Nope, I guess that's not a real thing. Alright, let's try this. Man, I cannot believe that this truck literally. Diff lock, duh. Here I am struggling. I forgot to put diff lock on it. That is not the way you want to go. I'm pretty sure I'm just digging this thing in deeper and deeper. There we go. I don't think we'll need diff lock anymore. All right, back on the road. So I got so distracted, I don't even know if I finished my sentence before, but we are gonna use this truck. Some of you may recognize this truck as the truck that got stuck doing the only thing we tried to use it for. I'm pretty sure it was just rescuing our other truck, so. Really haven't had good luck with it. But now that we can have, we got some levels, we can get some better tires. Get some fuel. Maybe with some better tires, stronger winch. Maybe with all that, this truck will be worth it. Have to see what engine options we have for this, because if we're gonna put that that semi-trailer on it, probably want a heavier engine in the front, although I'm not even sure it works that way. Thank you. Having extra weight on those front tires would definitely be nice. See what kind of options we have here. Oh, so we already have a bigger engine in it. I'm probably going to want low plus. I'm going to be impatient and want to go faster. It is raised. We have highway tires on it, which is definitely our issue. Those look good to me. Sell the highway tires because we're never using that again. Probably don't need the high power. I think the extender would be nice. Spare wheel I'm not worried about. Take the snorkel just in case. Another thing that we'll have to wait till Russia to find. That's a weird looking axle. It's not round on top. It's got a flat cover. Then I'm going to want the low saddle to pick up that trailer. Man, we have blown through money in the last couple episodes. All right. Now we have to go to Black River to get that trailer. Drifting down the hill. There we go. All right, back in Black River. Like it's been a while since we've been here. It's definitely been a while since we used that trailer, if it's still in here. Well, even with only a 4-speed, we're still banging on rocks. Damn, but this thing still feels fast as heck. Spent too much time driving the P16, I guess. That's a slide. That was impressive. Yeah, I should have went with like more all-terrain tires and less mud terrain. Alright, now this should pick up our oil rig drill. As long as this truck gets it there, should be back in business. Oh yeah, drifting the trailer now. Oh, good time for rain. Just in time to make it through that little muddy patch over there, and should be fine after that, so let it rain. Alright, first things first, let's get ourselves some gas. It doesn't look like we're going to pass any of the fuel I put on this map. It's a bigger engine. It's definitely thirsty. Alright, can I have an oil rig drill now? That's what I want. Alright, now. Now that we got our oil rig drill. To the site. Alright, GMC, now that you got fully loaded, better tires, this will be your first real off-road experience, I guess. I don't know if driving down the quarry counts as off-road, mostly just rock. This will be some actual dirt and mud, so don't get stuck on me. And even with the trailer loaded down, it still likes to slide loose. Alright, GMC, let's see how you do. Come on. There we go. All right, passed the first test. I think that lack of all-wheel drive means we're definitely bump steering the front of this around. So once we hit a wall, we'll turn that way. Not bad though. So far, so good for the GMC. I don't think it gets too much worse than this. At least the way we're going doesn't get too much worse than this. We're definitely not taking any crazy route to get there. I was just thinking how the diff lock doesn't seem super picky either, and then it had to complain. Well, if I'm gonna be in low gear, I might as well have diff lock. Just don't complain about it anymore. Probably just because I was going downhill. Diff lock never really likes going downhill. Come on. Nope. How'd you grab onto something that won't break? There we go. I guess I should have stayed more on the inside. The outside just looked better. I guess not. Didn't realize that one little pit of mud was going to be so deep. Well, that was steep. I really need like a button for diff lock and all-wheel drive on my shifter. That would make this so much easier. Man, we're almost there. Come on, around the bend. There it is. All right, now I got all my trucks in this one spot. Finish it up. Oh, too close. Shouldn't have stopped. We just kept going. What's the range? Can I get to it with something from over there? Yeah. Come on. There we go. How's that? Boom. All right, so I said the quarry and the ship were available, which should be more missions that are unlocked. Let's take a look at the map and see what we got. All right, so we already have the twin steer over here, so let's do this this heavy burden contest, which you're gonna need 3 service spare parts for. Pretty sure service spare parts. Maybe I should double check that. Yep, service spare parts. Not the cheapest thing to have to load up with without having a crane on this, but we're already here with it, so. And we should get a bit of a running start. We're so long, we could probably barely be in this. All So, oh, no real restrictions. Just 4.5 minutes to get gold. Let's go. Now, of course, once we get over there, we'll have like our entire fleet on this one section. Maybe we shouldn't have put the off-road trans in this. I think we'll be okay. Alright, the GMC can do it, so can you, Twin Steer. As long as you make the turn. Jeez, there we go. Well, that was super easy. Well, I think we have to start digging all of our trucks out from back by that oil rig. Ah, man, that's going to take a little while to get all those trucks from there, but I guess that's the plan. All right, well, I have no idea if P16 can even go this way, but we are going to find out. I can drag this with me. No. That's such a bad angle to it. Drive around it. There we go. Guess we'll take these two out of here first. man, this thing just keeps wanting to shift. And it just bogs down because it just can't handle fourth gear with this truck behind it. I wonder what the fuel usage would be if I turned on that other truck. I don't know if it saves any fuel, it's certainly faster. No, it definitely doesn't save any fuel. Not if I'm still going to be using 15 liters a minute driving through that. That's a tight gap. Hope we can squeeze through that. Come on. Push this GMC. There it is. Drag that truck through. Maybe I gotta release that for a second. Get myself back on the road here. I think this is supposed to be a D16 approved trail. Especially if it won't clear this tree. Come on, GMC, push me through. Yeah, there we go. Come on. Friggin' branches. There it is. It's probably just a little too tall. Alright, I don't know what you just connected to, but it looked like it was the ground. Find a bridge. Front wheels don't fit on the bridge. There we go. Come on. Oh, I don't think I'm fitting through that with this. there another way around? I mean, if I didn't have a turning radius of Florida, probably get around it. Oh, now the other truck is stuck. Damn it. Well, release the winch, because you're going to have to take some fuel out of it. I don't want to take all the fuel out of it. This is ridiculous. I really wish I could just take some fuel out of it. Are you hung up on that tree? Yeah, I hung up on that tree. Alright, I need a tree that's not super low. And I can push through. There we go. Was close enough. All right. Come on. Oh, the exhaust is hung up. I don't know if I'm going to be able to yank this through this way. Might work. Might not. I mean, definitely not if it tries grabbing something behind me. There we go. Alright, just pull it through. Just pull it through. Even trying to go anywhere, like, all right. This is ridiculous. I don't even know why it's stuck. Nor is anything going to get me unstuck, because I don't think my wheels are even really in the ground. Let's just leave you there for now. Maybe I can drag it forward with the stronger truck. Truck with no gas in it. Maybe I should have tried to put the GMC to there. No, not the. Spend more time trying to get the winch to line up something that I actually have use for. Drag the thing. That's taken care of. Made it out of there. There we go, we'll leave it 1 gallon of gas. Just get these to the main road. Really? A little bit of mud? Too much? There we go. That is 2 trucks brought out of there. And that'll have to do it for today's episode. If you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe. And I'll see everyone next time.